Well, this is hands-on equations, again, with a younger child. And this is Zach. And Zach, can you tell us a little bit about yourself, about how old you are and what grade you're going to be in next fall?
I'm 8. I'm going into third grade.
Okay. And you've been here at Island Village for a while, haven't you? How long?
3 years.
3 years. So this is something that I like to show you. I showed this with Dylan earlier. And this is a game that helps you find out the missing piece, the missing part of the puzzle. And you see this in front of us? This is a balance, okay? And this balance is always level. It is always the same. Yeah, whatever's on this side is the same on this side. It never moves from back and forth or anything like that. And the object of this game is to keep it in balance, to keep the contents in balance, okay? So I want to point your attention to these here. Now, these are red dice, but these do not stand for hundreds. These blue pawns, they do not stand for tens, okay? So you can take a look at these red dice in the same idea that we look at the red numerals when we put together equations. Okay? And this is what I call definite values. It's a known value. Alright? So if you wanted to make a 5, you'd place a 5 up like that. If you wanted to make a 13, you would still have to do this instead of just putting a 1 and a 3. But in order for us to notate it, we would do this, wouldn't we?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So I just wanted to show that to you so that we kept our code there. Okay? Alright, so in the meantime, you have two dice like this. They go from 6 to 10. I mean, from 5 to 10. And this, the other dice go from 0 to 5 instead of 1 to 6. So I just wanted to let you know, because sometimes whenever I put together whenever I assemble the numbers, sometimes I get a little mixed up. So you won't be the only person who got a little mixed up, okay? So in this essence, let's say that this blue pawn can stand for anything. It could be any sort of value. It's our missing piece, all right? And if I place a blue pawn here, and I place a 5 here, then obviously this tells me that this blue pawn equals 5, right? Okay, so let's clear the board. Let's say I take this blue pawn, let's say we have a 3 on the other side. Now, we see that this X, this blue pawn, is 3, isn't it? Okay. What we're going to do, and you might have heard me spit it out a little bit by accident. Start calling it by a name. And that name is X. And X is usually used in the situation of when you are finding an unknown value. Okay? So this is X. So when I say this number, can you set this up for me? I'm going to set this up. What if I say X equals 5? How would I set that up? Very good. Very good. Very good. And if I were to change it to this, can you set that up? Very good. Very good. Let's clear the scale while I clear the numerals, or rather the expression. And what we're going to look at for now something a little bit different. Can you please set up this equation? Oh, I think I forgot to mention something to you. When you see a 2 before an x, it means we need two x's. So 2x looks like this. And on the other side, we have a known value of 8. So when you look at this, what do you think x would be? Now remember, x is the same thing. It's the same number. We have two of the same number equaling 8. What does that tell you?
2x is equal 8.
So what must x equal?
X would equal like 5 or 3 or...
Mm-hmm. You know, I think it's time to test what x is. Now, you've recognized this before. These are rods that are colored in the same way as our bead stair. Okay? So how about if I pull out an 8, and what this says is that there's two of the same number that equals 8. Do you think you could find two bars that are the same and that would equal 8? Go right ahead. This is time to experiment. Well, you were close about your estimation. It was close to a 5. By the way, for those of you at home, this is the color for 4. So are you thinking that actually you've pretty much figured it out now, haven't you? X equals 4, right? Because 2 of 4 equals 8, and you can see that right there, and you can actually envision it sort of like this if you wanted to. Right? Okay, so let's put these back. And that's how you would figure this out. Let's do something a little bit different. Can you put this back here? We're gonna think of a, I'm gonna pull out a different one now. And what we're gonna do is set up an experimentation area, okay? And I'll put this right up here, okay? And I would like you to set this problem up. Can you do that? So we have 2x over here. And then we have a known value of 2. Wait a minute, known value. What are the known values? What do we use for known values? That's it. We have a known value of 8. And we have an x. Okay, so we can do trial and error with this. We might want to move our shoe back a little bit. And there's a number of ways that you can experiment. What we can do is that we can try certain numbers, couldn't we? Let's see if x equaled a certain number. Would one side equal the other side? Okay, because our goal typically is to have one x and a known value. And then we definitely know what x is. So this is what I'm going to ask you to do. I'm going to show you. Let's say we want to try 1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this here as a reminder that for this test, x is going to equal one, and this is going to be our test column. Okay? And down here, this is going to be our check area. And I'm going to move this up just a little bit because I have a funny feeling we're going to need some room if we're going to be testing. Okay? What is this known value?
Two.
Oops. What is this known value?
Eight.
What are we testing for x?
X equals one.
So how many ones do we need here? Can you place the ones below those two x's? Remember, this is a test. So you may go get some ones. Okay, and then we could put another one here, don't we? Okay, go ahead. So let's take a look. If x equals 1, we have a total of 1, 2, 4 on one side. Look at that.
9?
X cannot equal 1, could it? So this is a sign that we use in the check area saying that X, if X were 1, these two sides would not be equal. Right? Let's try another one. Let's try X equals 2. Could you get a 2 bar, please? How about our known values? Let's retrieve our known values. Let's get another 2 for this known value. Let's get another 8 for this known value. And what, and we'll keep this right over here. What is the x we're trying?
2.
So we'll need a 2 for x here. A 2 for x here, and a 2 for x here. Now, does it look like to you from here that x equals 2? We're going to have to check it, okay? By the way, if we skip count, 2, 4, 6. So this side equals 6, right? 8. Plus 2 is 10. Does 6 equal 10? No. So in our checking, we have confirmed that x does not equal 2. Okay. Why don't you place the known values over here again? Let's bring out a known value of 2 and a known value of 8, and then we'll try to plug in our next number. Go right ahead. With our bead bars or our bead rod or our rods. I'll set up the X. Is this a 2? No, it's an 8, remember? It's a known value. We have a known value of 2 and a known value of 8. Okay, keep it on this side. Now we're going to try an X of what?
X of 3.
Can you please get a 3 to show that this is what we're testing now? Now it's time to plug in the 3, isn't it? We'll place a 3 here. Ah, you knew that you needed to get 3 threes, huh? Looks like we're gonna have to do another one. You ready? Known values. I'll take care of the x for us. Okay. So what value are we going to test now?
6.
6.
6 plus 6 equals 12 plus 2 equals 14.
Mm-hmm. Let's put that in there again.
And 8 plus 6 equals 14. So they equal 6 plus 6 equals 12 plus 2 is 14, and 8 plus 6 equals 14.
So we've pretty much proven that x equals 6, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And this is 14. And this equals 14, right? And in order to let us know from now on, this is how we're going to show our confirmation, is that you will have x equals 6 and 14 equals 14, and that is how we say we have a correct check. You like it? We can do that with another problem a little bit later on. So this is what's going to happen. We'll clear everything, all right? I'll give you another problem, and you can put out an array just like this, and then show it to me.